Right now at 5, hundreds of high schoolers say goodbye to a significant chapter. Plus, NBC's Dateline looks into a Montana cold case. And meteorologist Matt Gray is tracking some spring-like temperatures for your work week.
Right now, this is NBC Montana News, getting the facts right.
Well, we are just 4 days away from finding out who will be Montana's next congressman. Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Montana McLaughlin. Elections offices across the state are now in crunch time for that special election. NBC Montana's Karen Farringer spoke with one office to find out what you need to know before the big day. Karen.
That's right, Montana. I went out to see what people are doing before casting their ballot this Thursday. People say they want to spend time researching the candidates before casting their vote. Polling stations say they are testing their digital scan machines tomorrow. Although a lot of preparation is still underway, officials say Missoula is lagging behind some other counties for returned ballots. We spoke to Missoula County Elections Administrator Rebecca Connors to find out why.
Yellowstone County is over 60% returned. They're at 65% return. Gallatin has more absentee ballots back than Missoula does. And so we're really encouraging voters, if you have a voted ballot at home, get it to us Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of next week.
Connors anticipates a 55% voter turnout this election. That's 20% lower than November's presidential election. Election day is this Thursday, May 25th. Live in Missoula, Karen Farringer, NBC Montana.
It was a packed room at Montana State University today in Bozeman as Bernie Sanders rallied in support of congressional candidate Rob Quist. Here's a photo of that crowd. Energy still high after Sanders' visit to Missoula, Butte, and Billings yesterday. The Missoula and Billings venues were even changed last minute to accommodate for the growing number of attendees. Our Will Wadley sat down with both Rob Quist and Greg Gianforte, the Republican candidate for Montana's special election. They spoke about each candidate's platform and plans if they make it to Washington. Here's a preview of what Gianforte had to say about the Trump administration's involvement with Russia.
I would call on the administration to release any information they have to bring clarity to the situation, because honestly, the American people don't want to be sidetracked by this stuff. We need to get to the bottom of it. We need to be completely transparent in our government, but then we need to get back to the business of government.
You can catch the full interviews, including the one with Rob Quist as well, right here on NBC Montana this Monday and Tuesday night. Well, it was a beautiful day for Western Montana today, Matt, but how long will this last? I know you're tracking some changing conditions.
That's right, and changing conditions, but it's going to be a little bit later on. So expect, if you are enjoying the sunny weather, expect it to hang around here for at least a couple more days. And here it is outside right now. A few clouds, but overall lots of sunshine across the region. 60s right now in Butte, Bozeman, 70s in Missoula and Kalispell. Pretty quiet out there on the radar, but a few showers have popped up here this afternoon. One just to the east of the Livingston area and some others in the Crazy Mountains. Also had a few in Jefferson County and then north into the Helena area. Just a few light sprinkles, nothing too serious for us to worry about. Overnight, partly cloudy skies. Temperatures will drop into the 40s for Missoula and Kalispell. Bozeman will drop to around 40 and will be in the 30s. Around the Butte area. Now, some places do have a little bit better chance for showers tomorrow, and we will tell you where coming up.
Well, when that sunshine does come out, you might want to head outdoors, but be warned because it is also the start of tick season. The Centers for Disease Control suggest avoiding wooded and brushy areas with high grass. They also say it's important to walk in the center of trails. Health officials say to use repellent that contains 20% or more of DEET on exposed skin. To remove a tick, use fine-tipped tweezers and try to get as close to the skin's surface as possible. Well, new information tonight you need to know if you're planning to attend the funeral processions for Broadwater County Sheriff's Deputy Mason Moore this Tuesday. Moore died after a shootout that ended in Missoula County last week. Moore's services start with the procession through Townsend at 8:30 a.m. this Tuesday. The public's encouraged to line Broadway Street. The procession will go down Highway 287 and I-90 to the bridge at Belgrade Church by 11 a.m. Now, that service is private, but it will be simulcast for the public at Three Forks School Gym and at the Belgrade Event Center from 11 to 1:30. Classes at Three Forks School will be canceled on Tuesday as well. Organizers say that the public should be aware of significant traffic delays and leave plenty of time to find parking at each venue. You can park from Main to Grogan Streets in the Grogan lot. There will be volunteer flaggers there to help you out. Shuttle buses will run from Three Forks School to several locations in town. You can find much more information on all of this at NBCMontana.com. Well, today, 35 graduates from Butte Central Catholic High School turned their tassels, marking the end of a long road. Now, the ceremony a little different than most. Before making their graduation official, students and their families sat through a short Catholic Mass. It honors the achievements and hard work of the class of 2017. Students tell us that finishing their high school careers with a Mass makes this day extra special. Some of them say the memories they made in high school will last a lifetime, but before parting ways, they left this advice for incoming freshmen.
Just be smart during high school. Don't get in trouble and study a lot. Keep your grades up.
Be yourself and have fun and definitely work hard because it pays off in the end and you just definitely know how to follow your dreams and be true to yourself.
And tonight, 36 seniors are celebrating after graduating from Loyola Sacred Heart High School. The school celebrated the class of 2017 with a breakfast award ceremony, followed by Mass and commencement at St. Anthony Catholic Church. Class speakers reminisced about their time together and shared their fondest memories of each classmate. This fall, graduates will be attending colleges around the country at universities in more than 10 states. Now, we're not done with graduation season just yet. NBC Montana is saluting all of our graduates in the class of 2017. We're trying to make it to all of them, but we need your help to do that. We created a slideshow on our website and Facebook page. You can join in on our salute and send us your favorite graduation pictures from any ceremony. Be sure to include the school, the date, and the name of your special graduate. You can find all graduation dates on our website, NBCMontana.com. Just click on the 2017 graduations fast link. Well, starting tomorrow, your commute around Missoula could look a little different. Construction will begin here along Brook Street on the right southbound lane between Garfield and Grant Streets. It's all to build a new entrance to the Southgate Mall. Crews say to expect delays and lane closures through the end of June. This project joins three other road construction projects in town already causing delays. Those are on Orange Street and Madison Street. The Missoula Police Department is asking for your help to identify a man suspected of stealing credit cards. They're looking for this man. Police say he used stolen credit cards at a local home improvement store and purchased a large appliance, then loaded it into a newer looking white van. Anyone with information is asked to contact the Missoula Police Department. The Ravalli Valley County Sheriff's Office is also warning the public against a new IRS phone scam. Sheriff Steve Holton says that someone claiming to be with the IRS is threatening people with arrest warrants if they don't provide financial information. Holton says the IRS does not contact people by telephone. He says if you receive a call like this, simply hang up. Lots of action to talk about in City Council this week. Missoula City Council is set to approve nearly $600,000 for checks made up to May 23rd. They will also approve just under $10,000 in water claims related to the acquisition of Mountain Water tomorrow. Bozeman will vote to authorize the new interim city manager to award the bid to reconstruct East Peach Street. Now, that bid costs about $850,000. Butte Silver Bow City Council Committee will open bids for this year's sidewalk program there as well. And in Kalispell, City Council will analyze their population growth policy. The draft hopes to establish goals and policies to improve the city's zoning laws and development plans. Well, it's been 4 years since Kalispell resident Nicole Waller went missing in western Montana. But this year, a judge sentenced her former boyfriend, Cody Wayne Johnston, to life in prison for her murder. This Sunday, Dateline takes us inside the search for Waller and her killer. And as our Christopher Salas says, it's still fresh in her family's mind.
We've been reporting on the story for years. Kalispell resident Nicole Waller went missing after a trip to eastern Montana. Now Dateline NBC catches up with her family to talk about her disappearance.
My mom knew something was wrong. She's like, what's going on? And I had to tell her. And I'm like, I just got the phone call that Nikki's missing. My mom's like, what? And she's screaming at me on the phone. And it wasn't that she was mad at me. It's fear. So I had to tell my mom her daughter's missing.
4 years later, then-boyfriend Cody Wayne Johnston has been charged and sentenced with life in prison for the murder. According to charging documents we received, Waller texted Keebler on February 13, 2013, that she would be home the next day. Keebler told NBC Montana in a previous interview,
"Mom and I called every, you know, hospital, clinic, any place we could think of from here to North Dakota."
That when she was announced missing the next day, panic ensued. Waller's car was found abandoned soon after. According to the charging documents, investigators believe after Johnston murdered Waller, he hid her body in a barrel, and they haven't been able to recover it since. But in our previous interviews, Keebler tells NBC Montana she's never going to stop looking for her sister.
"I'm not going to give up. I hound, you know, the law enforcement agencies all the time. What's new? What's going on?"
Reporting in Kalispell, Christopher Salas, NBC Montana.
And that two-hour Dateline special, Under the Prairie Sky, airs tonight at 6 o'clock. Well, just after the break, President Trump takes his first trip overseas. We'll tell you what's on his agenda. Plus, let's take you out now, a live look over to Missoula, even seeing some nice blue skies today. Matt Gray has your work week forecast.
More people than ever are making the move to Nissan. Save on Rogue, America's best-selling SUV, only at Nissan's Make the Move event. Hurry, event ends soon. Get 0% for up to 72 months on 11 models.
Higher taxes, bigger government, liberal extremists are threatening Montana's way of life. Thankfully, Greg Gianforte is an experienced leader who will fight government overreach and grow our Montana economy. Greg built a small business into one of Montana's largest employers, creating hundreds of high-paying jobs. And he's providing opportunities for Montana's next generation to help us do even more. On May 25th, vote Greg Gianforte for Congress. The U.S. Chamber is responsible for the content of this advertising.
Rob Quist and Nancy Pelosi aren't telling you the truth. They're desperate to hide Quist's support for a national gun registry.
"Don't believe the false attacks. Greg Gianforte never blocked access to this stream. I know because I've fished here for years. Greg Gianforte will fight for our access to public lands."
Greg Gianforte. He'll protect the Second Amendment and keep public lands in public hands.
I'm Greg Gianforte, and I approve this message.
More people than ever are making the move to Nissan. Save on Rogue, America's best-selling SUV, only at Nissan's Make the Move event. Get up to $1,500 Memorial Day bonus cash on top of existing offers.
This segment of the news is brought to you by Fred's Appliance.
Welcome back. Well, President Donald Trump addressed Muslim leaders in Saudi Arabia today, calling on them to help combat what he calls a crisis of Islamic extremism. NBC's Hallie Jackson reports from Saudi Arabia.
President Trump is wrapping up day two of his first international trip as president, and the most significant part of it was a speech he delivered earlier today to more than 50 Middle Eastern leaders. In it, the president talked about the need to combat extremism abroad, putting the burden, he said, on Muslim nations to, in his words, drive them out.
"There is still much work to be done. That means honestly confronting the crisis of Islamic extremism and the Islamicists and Islamic terror of all kinds."
It was a notably softer tone regarding Islam than what we have seen from President Trump before, even as he had tough words against Iran, something that is sure to be received well by his Saudi hosts.
"For decades, Iran has fueled the fires of sectarian conflict and terror. It is a government that speaks openly of mass murder, vowing the destruction of Israel, death to America, and ruin for many leaders and nations in this very room."
The president heads to Israel tomorrow for a trip that is certain to be full of diplomatic landmines. Hallie Jackson, NBC News, Riyadh.
While Trump continues his first overseas trip, Congress is now moving forward with investigations into Russia's involvement in the election. They're now calling in help from a special counsel to find out if Trump tried to impede an FBI probe. Today, those in the Oval Office spoke about what they heard after a special meeting where the president allegedly called ex-FBI Director James Comey a, quote, nut job.
"There have been so many lies, so many contradictions, and I think documents will help us to ferret out exactly what's the truth and what's a lie.
I'm almost speechless because I don't know why someone would say something like that.
Officials say Comey may be just days away from breaking his silence after President Trump fired him. The House Oversight Committee has now invited the former FBI director to testify this Wednesday.
And now Matt Gray with your forecast.
All right, Matt, well, we know warmer temperatures possibly for our work week, but I know you are tracking the chance of some showers in some places tomorrow.
That's right. So showers in some places, and just how long is that warmth going to last? Mm-hmm. We'll give you a preview on that here as well. Meanwhile, gorgeous day across many parts of western Montana. A lot of snow up in those mountains in Lake McDonald and Glacier National Park. Pretty tranquil as you head into the lower elevations. We're in the 70s across western Montana right now, 72s and 73s across the area. Expect us to be dipped down into the 60s by 8 o'clock and in the 50s as we head towards 10. Nice looking day in Yellowstone as well. People already going back and forth as we get closer and closer to the big summertime tourist season. Evening outlook here, partly cloudy skies. We're in the 60s currently. Expect us to stay that way through the 8 o'clock hour. Overnight temperatures will be a little bit warmer across many parts of southwest Montana, so we'll be flirting with the 30s, but many of us will not get there. 40 in Bozeman and Dillon, 37, however, in Butte, 39 in Ennis, and mid-40s as you head down the Missouri. Townsend and Helena will be there. 43 in both Missoula and Kalispell, and middle 40s for Thompson Falls and Libby. As we've gone throughout the day, this is from the last 3 hours, a wet day, a showery day in eastern Montana, but only a few light sprinkles around the Livingston area or up and down the mountains of the Continental Divide. But we're going to have a better shot for showers in some of the eastern parts of our viewing area as we head into tomorrow. And so if you're in Bozeman, you should be on the lookout for a few showers as we are going to see some work their way into the area. Right around the noon hour, within a few hours of that, that's where we're going to be looking for those showers. Conditions will improve a little bit, I think, as we head on into the afternoon. Temperatures will thus remain in the 60s. We're not going to warm up all that much because of the clouds and the showers in the area. About a 20% chance of showers for any given hour in the Butte area, but there will be some sprinkles hanging around the area. 60s here as well, and a little bit cooler in the morning. Now, as you head further west, under more of an influence of some drier and much warmer air, well, that means we're going to get well up into the 70s, into the middle 70s around the Kalispell area in the afternoon. And for Missoula, we're talking about a quick jump from the 50s to the upper 60s by lunchtime, and then all the way into the middle and upper 70s around the Missoula area as we head on into the afternoon. So plenty of sunshine. So if you live west of the Continental Divide, by and large, you should have a pretty decent Monday. So here are your highs. Further west you go, the warmer it is. 80 in Thompson Falls, 81 for Libby. We're going to see more 80s on Tuesday as well. 76 for Kalispell, 77 in Missoula. Hamilton hit 75, 65, however, in Butte, and 65 as well in Bozeman. We're going to keep it green on the severe weather tracker. Not too much for us to be worrying about, although we're going to keep an eye on some windy weather from Sunday as the storm system drops down from Canada. It should stay to the north of us along with most of the moisture. But as we head into Thursday, we're going to see winds come out of the northwest. That's a good setup for showers, especially because we'll have more moisture in the area with this storm nearby. So windy Wednesday and then showery conditions for the rest of the week. So here's your outlook here. And through the weekend, we're going to be looking at showery weather, isolated lightning strikes. Temperatures will fall back to the 60s in Bozeman. Around the Butte area, 70s for a day, but then 60s and 50s Thursday through Saturday with a little bit of recovery on Sunday. Around the Missoula area, 80s, 82 on Tuesday, lots of sunshine, cloudier and much cooler on Wednesday, breezy as well, and then showers Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, and maybe even a little bit on Sunday before another warming trend looks like maybe in the forecast for us next week. 80 on Tuesday in Kalispell, and then a quick drop, 20-degree drop to 60 degrees and clouds and maybe even a few showers for the Flathead on Wednesday. So a quick little burst of heat, and then we're back down to average to below average.
Well, I know I'm liking at least seeing 80 degrees on the 7-day outlook.
So. Yeah, it's kind of been nice to see for once in a while.
Awesome. Well, great. Thanks, Matt. Well, Tyler, beautiful day for some sports.
That's right. Coming up, the state's best high school lacrosse teams are up in Great Falls this week for the state championships. Two teams familiar with each other, both on the boys and girls side. They were facing off today. We'll have highlights and scores after the break.
A defaulted loan.
tax liens, collections, foreclosure notices.
Rob Quist has a long history of running up debt.
This has been going on for 16 years.
I'm sharing my story because I don't want somebody else to be taken advantage of by Rob Quist.
In Washington, Rob Quist would run up debt and stick us with the bill.
If he doesn't pay his bills, how can we trust him in Washington?
We can't afford to send Rob Quist to Washington.
The NRCC is responsible for the content of this advertising.
Every truck guy has their own way of conveying powerful.
Yeah, boy.
Kind of looks like a monster coming to eat you.
Holy smokes.
That is awesome.
Strong. You got the basic and you got the beefy.
I just think it looks mean.
Incredible.
No way. I'm getting goosebumps.
It's the Chevy Memorial Day sales event. Find your tag and get over $9,300 total value on select Silverado crew cabs when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Your day means getting from point A to point B, as in bank or ballet. G for gym, W for work. When what you drive needs tires or service, get to point S, Tire and Auto, a trusted neighbor with the right tires for how and where you drive, and certified techs to take care of what you drive. So you get to all the points in your day and home again safely. Get to the point, point S Tire and Auto Service. Expert service guaranteed.
How would you like to save money on heating and air conditioning? Hi, I'm David, owner of Air Quality Mechanical. Did you know it's possible to transform any room in your home into an oasis of comfort? Cool and dry in the summer and warm and cozy in the winter.
Daikin heating and cooling systems let you control your comfort in each and every room.
Simply set the temperature for each room with an easy-to-use remote and save money all year long, year after year. For more information and a free estimate, please call Air Quality Mechanical, 721-7018.
This segment of the news is brought to you by Jeep. And now, sports with Tyler Bergen.
Welcome back. Another state championship day today throughout Montana. This time, we're taking you to Great Falls for the 2017 lacrosse state title games. The Bozeman Hawks made it to the big game this year, trying to dethrone the five-time defending champion Hellgate Knights. We'll start in the first quarter. Hellgate already up 1-0 and on the attack again. Jacob Richmond finds a hole in the defense and fires one on net. And good to give the Nets a 2-0, give the Knights a 2-0 lead, rather. Going the other way now, the Hawks using some good ball movement on offense. Tommy Holloway gets it in open space and launches one at the keeper. He can't react fast enough. That's the first goal of the game for Bozeman. This one's in the fourth quarter right now. The Hawks are leading it 10-9. We'll have the rest of the highlights and your final score tonight at 10. And prior to that game, check out this. The same two teams went at it for the girls' state championship, Bozeman against Hellgate, and what a game it was. Bozeman wins a thriller in Great Falls, 9-8 in two overtimes. The Legion baseball season is in full swing now, and for the second weekend in a row, the Helena Senators made the trip to Missoula to take on the Mavs. Let's get to the highlights of game one of the doubleheader this afternoon. Helena picked up a run in the first and looking for more in the second as Tanner McMahon grounds one to the shortstop Dylan Chalmers for a chance at a double play, but his throw to first sails high and away from the bag. That would allow another run to come in for Helena. They go up 2-0. Next inning, Colin Sassano at the dish. He's going to go with the pitch to right center in that spacious outfield. He'll dig for third on the play, while another Senators run is going to cross home plate, extending their lead to 3-0. Bottom four now, Missoula looking for its first run of the game. Sam Busey's going to help that cause with a rocket to left field, clearing the fielder's glove and dropping for a hit. Spencer Schock comes in to score to make it 3-1, but that's all the scoring the Mavs could manage in game one. They fall 3-1 the final. The NHL has two pretty good conference finals going on right now. Let's take a look at one of those series that you saw right here on NBC earlier today. The Senators and Penguins all tied 2-2 in the Eastern Conference Finals series. Early in the first period of this one, Penguins force a steal, get it to an open Ali Mata, who fires one on net. Pittsburgh goes up 1-0 in front of its home crowd. A few minutes later, Trevor Daly is going to take a shot on goal, and look who is there to deflect it into the net. That's Sidney Crosby. He collects yet another playoff goal with that one as they go up 2-0. The Penguins would go on a scoring spree in the first period. A perfect game from their goalie helped pave the way for a 7-0 blowout to take a 3-2 lead in the series. And one more playoff game scheduled for tonight. The Cleveland Cavaliers bring their perfect postseason record back home to host the Celtics in Game 3. No Isaiah Thomas for the Celtics the rest of the way for these playoffs. Tip-off is going to be at 6:30. And that'll do it for your sports. We'll be right back.
This segment of the news is brought to you by Ashley Furniture.
A defaulted loan. Tax liens. Collections. Foreclosure notices.
Rob Quist has a long history of running up debt.
This has been going on for 16 years.
I'm sharing my story because I don't want somebody else to be taken advantage of by Rob Quist.
In Washington, Rob Quist would run up debt and stick us with the bill.
If he doesn't pay his bills, how can we trust him in Washington?
We can't afford to send Rob Quist to Washington.
The NRCC is responsible for the content of this advertising. The internet changed how talent's discovered. And now we're changing the way you get internet. With CenturyLink high-speed internet, we'll help you find the speed you need for surfing the web, streaming the shows you love, or becoming an internet sensation yourself without overpaying. CenturyLink, your link to what's next.
It's Wrangler's Brother RV Center's Spring into Summer Sales Event. Escape into the freedom of the open road and the great outdoors in a Jayco Class A motorhome like the Elante, with luxurious travel and comfortable pricing starting at only $79,995. Elante features J-Ride, guaranteeing the smoothest ride on the road today. Or spring into savings on our huge selection of new Class C motorhomes with payments as low as $400 a month OAC. Gear up and hit the road in style with a new motorhome from Jayco. Only where a handshake means something, Wrangler's Brother RV Center.
Justice comes for us all in the end.
It's finally time you paid for all the things you've done, Harley.
This is surrender.
The Shades of Blue 2-hour season finale, tonight 9, 8 central on NBC. From Jennifer Lopez.
That's what I'm talking about!
The biggest.
It was amazing. It was amazing.
Dance competition.
You dominated.
In the world.
Wow!
World of Dance premieres Tuesday, May 30th on NBC.
All right, one more look at your temperatures for tomorrow before we get out of here. And pretty warm. Talk about some 80s possible around Sanders, Mineral, and Lincoln counties. Middle 70s up in middle to upper 70s and Highway 93. It's still in the 60s with a few showers possible around Butte and Bozeman, but 70s, maybe even a stray 80 or two are possible in southwest Montana as we go into Tuesday. Tuesday is going to be the day to get outside, bask in a little bit of vitamin D.
Great. Thanks, Matt. A little bit of taste of summer there. Well, that does it for us. We will be back tonight at 10. But in the meantime, you can always get more local news at NBCMontana.com and on our Instagram as well. That's at NBC_Montana. Our Barrett Chions managing that. Thanks for joining us. Have a great night.